Hey, while you're in the first 5 seconds of the video, go ahead, like and subscribe.
Everything that we do today has been learned behavior. We learned this behavior over the generations coming out of chattel slavery, right? We learned this being oppressed by the so-called white man and the other nations. This is learned behavior. By them putting certain things on TV, and we growing up watching Uncut BET, we watching Menace in Society, Boys in the Hood. This is learned behavior that you see. Then they stick us in the ghettos with no money, no jobs. And now, what are we going to do? Right? We're going to survive. We're going to do our instincts. Survival instincts are going to kick in. And we're going to go to the coastal resources, which they gave us, which was drugs.
Bring it up.
Prostitution.
Right.
Pimps. So they put these things in our, they put us in a situation to starve.
Right.
And then put ways for us to make money.
Bring it out.
That was going to kill us even more, though.
That's right.
So now all they got to do is step back and say, all right, let them kill each other.
Right.
Go to Titus 3:3 real quick first. I want to show something. Because we was all crazy. We all had this mind. I don't want us to sit up here. We ain't on no soapbox showing our people that we just woke born. We was born like this.
Bring it
we
up.
We was born with this understanding. We wasn't. We had to change. We all had to make a change because we started to cave state or the destroyed state of our people. And we said, you know what? Enough is enough. We got to change.
Bring it up.
Read. Titus chapter 3 verse 3. For we ourselves also were sometimes foolish, disobedience, deceived, serving diverse lusts. So the Bible says that we, us as the prophets of God, we were ourselves sometimes disobedient. We did these things, Isaiah, right? We slept from women and women, right? We got high, we dealt with gangs, right? A lot of us sold drugs. A lot of us were thieves, right? But we woke up, we said, you know what? Enough is enough. We got enough of that going on around here. And where is it leading us? Nowhere fast. Breathe.
For we ourselves were sometimes foolish, disobedient, deceived, serving diverse lusts.
We served our diverse lusts too at one point. But we got to be disciplined. We woke up and said, you know what? We got to do better than this. But it takes discipline. It takes discipline, daily discipline. Read.
And pleasures, living in malice, envy, hateful, and hating one another.
Because how do our sisters dress around here? The way our sisters dress, You gonna look, right? You might take a second look and a third, right? Now those thoughts are in your head, right? That's why God says, give me that, 1 Timothy. Modest apparel. So things, we got distractions all around. That's why I asked you about high school. These distractions are all around us, the way our sisters dress. So now we go after, it entices our lust, and now we wanna go after her and we wanna sleep with her. So as us as a community, we have to play a part. We have to realize and say, you know what? Sisters, we can't dress like this because what? It entices the men.
Bring it up.
We should be showing our curves, right? We should put on something modest. And the Bible says the same thing. Read on. Read.
1 Timothy chapter 2, verse 9. Mm-hmm. In like manner also, mm-hmm. that women adorn themselves in modest apparel.
Read it again.
In like manner also.
So God says, in this manner, read.
That women adorn themselves in modest apparel.
God tells the woman, the Black, Hispanic, and Native American woman to adorn themselves in modest apparel. Why? Not because somebody's trying to make you a homebody or I feel old or No, it's so you don't tempt your brother. Your brother don't see your ass cheeks and you tempt him and now he's going after his lust to try and holler at you.
Bring it up.
Baby mama. It's for your own good, sister. Read.
With shamefacedness.
Same face, being humble, read.
And sobriety.
Being sober, read. Y'all sisters get a flyer.
Not with braided hair, uh-huh. Or gold, uh-huh. Or apparel,
uh-huh.
Or costly array,
uh-huh.
But which becometh woman professing godliness.
So not all about the fashion and the newest this and the newest that. Not that there's wrong, nothing wrong with dressing nice. We understand, but more professing holiness versus over just trying to look good.
Bring it out.
You understand, my bro? You got a question? You believe what we're saying? How this sound to you, bro? It's something that'll change the community. What you think? You get a flyer? You got one? What you think? Is this something that can change the community?
Yeah.
Is this something that you would be a part of? That's what we out here for. We out here to gather the 12 tribes of the nation of Israel so we can get out of here, so we can set our people in order, and then we can get the kingdom of heaven, which is eternal life on earth, which is rulership of the planet earth. All right, but you got to believe that, bro. What's your name? Reggie. You got to believe that, though, Reggie. If you believe it, come build with us. Reggie.
Woman professing godliness.
Women professing godliness, but it starts with us men. Titus 2, let's get the man. Let's get the aged man. It starts with us men. Us men got to come back to our, we got to come back and set brothers like Isaiah in order and get him on the right path so he don't become a statistic out here. So he don't become, he don't fall for the hype. He don't get duped and tricked out here to becoming, to going to jail for the rest of his life. So he don't get duped becoming a baby father, right? Or becoming a stick-up man. We don't want that for Isaiah. Read.
Titus chapter 2, verse 3.
Uh-huh.
The aged woman likewise, that they be in behavior as becoming holiness, not false accusers, not giving too much wine, teachers of good things, that they may teach the young woman to be sober, to love their husbands, to love their children.
So if you notice, all of this is taught behavior. Just like everything that we do today has been learned behavior. We learned this behavior over the generations coming out of chattel slavery, right? We learned this being oppressed by the so-called white man and the other nations. This is learned behavior. By them putting certain things on TV and we growing up watching Uncut BET, we watching Menace in Society, Boys in the Hood. This is learned behavior that you see. Then they stick us in the ghettos with no money, no jobs. And now what are we gonna do? Right? We're going to survive. We're going to do our instincts. Survival instincts are going to kick in. And we're going to go to the closest resources, which they gave us, which was drugs.
Big it
which
up.
Was prostitution.
Right.
Pimps. So they put these things in our, they put us in a situation to starve.
Right.
And then put ways for us to make money.
Big it out.
That was going to kill us even more, though.
That's right.
So now all they got to do is step back and say, all right, let them kill each other.
Right.
You understand? Give me Psalms 83. Give me Psalms 83. We are victims of Crafty Counsel. We are victims, Isaiah, of being of a, that's why they call it, what they call it, the ghetto. They call it the project. We a bunch of experiments, right, the project. We a bunch of experiment people out here, man. Just generations of an experiment that worked. But
that's
God
right.
said, you know what, I'm gonna leave a remnant out here that's not gonna get duped, that's gonna wake up and say, you know what, go out here and I teach the people. I'm gonna pour my spirit upon all flesh.
Bring it up.
Go out here and teach the people who they are. Tell them who they are. Wake them up. It's Read. Time. We're Read. Getting out of here. Read.
It's the book of Psalms, chapter 83, verse 1.
Uh-huh.
Keep not thy silence, O God. Uh-huh. Hold not thy peace.
Uh-huh.
And be not still, O God. For lo, thine enemies make a tumult.
So God, so the Bible is saying, keep not your silence, O God. Meaning, God, we need you right now. We need you to rise up. We need some help. We drowning out here. We hurt. We don't see no way. And what I say when we talk, bro, we talking out of love, man. You know what I'm saying? The love hurt. You know what I'm saying? The truth hurt. But it's love, but it's to build our people up. Read.
For lo, thine enemies make a tumult.
God has enemies. Everybody say they love God. God, believe it or not, has enemies. People hate God, man. Read.
That's right. And they that hate thee have lift up their head.
Uh-huh.
They have said, they have taken crafty counsel against thy people.
So God said a group of people have taken crafty counsel against you, Isaiah. It's a group of people that set up that school that you in to make it, they call it a school to prison pipeline. You got a group of people that said, set these schools up, set them up just like jails, so that when they leave these schools, they're going straight to jail. When they leave these schools, they're not getting educated, they're getting miseducated. That's going to turn them to the streets and lead them to a life of crime, and then they're going straight to jail. We got them. Jail is big business. Read.
They have taken crafty counsel against thy people.
The Bible says they taken crafty counsel, slick counsel. Like they sat back and said, man, how can we destroy these niggas? You understand? How can we get over? How can we destroy the black family? How can we destroy the black man? How can we destroy the black children? They sitting back. It's a group of people that are sitting back plotting on our lives. Plotting on your life, Isaiah. I ain't talking about your brother next door either. I'm talking about people in high places. I'm talking about people in the United States government or the other nations. They want to see you at the bottom. They don't want you to know this truth.
Why?
Because your truth, you knowing this truth, means their demise. meaning they go down to the bottom and you come up. All right, so they got to keep us asleep. Read.
And consulted against the hidden ones.
They consulted against the hidden ones, because just like we read in Revelation, the revealing of who this was versus who that was, the Bible says God calls us the hidden ones. Nobody knows that we the real Jews. Nobody knows that we are the nation of Israel. We are the hidden ones. Did you hear that you was a Jew before today? You heard that before? What you think? From down there, right? Our brothers down the street, right? Okay, so come on that. They doing their job. But before that, you didn't know nothing about the Jews. Right. All praise. So you getting it twice today, huh? So the Lord dealing with you, Isaiah. This ain't a light thing, man. All right, read.
They have said, come and let us cut them off from being a nation.
They said what?
They have said, come and let us cut them off from being a nation.
That's what I was saying. We are products of crafty counsel. They said, come, let us cut them off from being a nation. Let us cut the nation of it so that they don't know that they're a nation anymore. Let us cut them off from their heritage, from their laws, from their statutes, from their commandments. Let us cut them off from their God. Let's give them white Jesus. Give them white supremacy so that they don't know that they are the gods of the earth. Read.
They have said, come and let us cut them off from being a nation. Uh-huh. That the name of Israel may be no more in remembrance.
That what?
That the name of Israel may be no more in remembrance.
They said, make it so that the name of Israel is no more in remembrance. Now when you say Israel, you think, oh, the white people over there in the land.
It worked.
You think that it worked. That thing worked, man. Because our people, we don't know who we are. We think we black, which is a color. We think we African-American, which is two white men. We think we Negro, that just means black. Now we think we Moors, that just means black. Hispanic. Now we think we, yeah, exactly. So our people are under so many different names. God, that means that the crafty council worked. But God said, no, I'm going to have a remnant that's going to teach my people who they are. God said that the name of Israel said not remain no more. Since you are Israelite, you got to keep the commandments of God. Read up on that. Read.
That the name of Israel may be no more in remembrance.
That word, read.
For they have consulted together with one consent.
They consulted together. The other nations, Isaiah, consulted together with one consent. With one agreement. With one thought, right? Read.
They are confederate against thee. Uh-huh. The tabernacles of Edom.
So now he's going to name some nations that did this. That came against us. Read.
The tabernacles of Edom.
Tabernacles of Edom. Edom is the so-called white man, or the Edomites. The Edomites are the so-called white people today. Read.
And the Ishmaelites.
The Ishmaelites are the so-called Arabs today. You ever heard of Ishmael? That's the so-called Arabs today. Read.
Of Moab.
Moab is the so-called Chinese. So-called Chinese today is Moab. Read.
And the Hagarenes.
And the Hagarenes are the so-called Africans. We're not African. We're the Israelites. We're Semites. The Africans are Hamites. We're two different people. Read.
Gebal.
Uh-huh.
And Ammon.
And Ammon. Ammon is a so-called Japanese. They're the Japanese man today. Read on.
And the Amalek.
Uh-huh. Amalek is Edom. Amalek is more Edomite, or the so-called Jewish man. The guy over there right now that stole our identity. That's claiming to be us. He said they are all in cahoots to say, you know what, let's cut them off from being a nation. We're going to steal their identity, and we're going to call them, we're going to tell them that they're black, we're going to tell them that they're Hispanic. The only reason why the so-called Hispanics speak Spanish, because they was conquered by the Spanish. That's not an original language. The original language to you so-called Hispanic is Hebrew. All right? You're the Israelites according to God. Read.
The Philistines, uh-huh, with the inhabitants of Tyre, mm-hmm, Assur also is joined with them. They have holpen the children of Lot, mm-hmm, Selah.
So God said that these other nations will come against us and use crafty counsel to cut us off from being a nation so that the name of Israel shall be in no more remembrance. So now when we ask Isaiah in 2024, who is he? He'll say, I don't know. I've never heard of a Jew. I never heard that I was a Jew before.
What is a nation? Nation is men leading by example. family. Nation is community. Nation is children with role models.